Hello and welcome to Curator with a Camera. I'm Anthony Coulls, Senior Curator of Rail Transport and Technology at the National Railway Museum. And today, we're going to have a look at a locomotive from the Victorian period, the 1846 built Coppernob. Now, the National Railway Museum is a vibrant museum. There's always something going on. So we've got a little bit of work going on in the background at the moment, which you might hear a few clatters and bangs, but it's a sign of a living, working, breathing museum, which is part of the excitement of working here. But what we've got that we're looking at today is Coppernob. Coppernob was a locomotive made by a company in Liverpool, Berry, Curtis and Kennedy, and the leading exponent of that company was Edward Berry. So in the early 19th century, there were two schools of engineering. There was the Stevenson School of Engineering and there was the Edward Berry School of Engineering. Berry was an engineer, he had his own company in Liverpool, Berry, Curtis and Kennedy latterly, but he was also involved with the Great Northern Railway. And he had his own ideas. Stevenson's had built Rocket, they were building engines like Planet and Patentee and Firefly, and they had their idea of how locomotives should be and how they should look. Edward Berry dared to be different. His locomotives looked very different. He went for a light and economic design, easy in construction, easy in maintenance, and certainly a lot less heavy than some of his contemporaries. But the main thing is, he stuck with four wheels. And so Coppernob is a four-wheel tender engine, known as an 040 wheel arrangement, with the cylinders inside connecting the pistons to the back axle via the crank and the connecting rods, and there's the inside motion there as well, which activates the valves. But what sets it apart from the Stevenson type locomotive is the materials and the method in which it's made from the actual wheels and the chassis of the engine itself. The structure, the frame, the heart of the locomotive. You haven't got plate steel available in 1846 when this engine is made, and so Berry creates what he calls the bar frame here. And you can see just that very thin piece of wrought iron. And that's mirrored at a higher level with another strut going along. And that's called the bar framed locomotive. And that's Berry's patent. This is simplicity in itself. You know, one set of driven wheels, one set of carrying wheels linked together by this piece of wrought iron. And it's as simple as that. It's amazing that something so spindly lasts for so long and can pull such, not enormous trains, but such effective and useful and economic trains. But you can see at the front of the engine just how lightly made it is, because on many modern locos, the buffer beam and the coupling, they're all, you know, huge constructions riveted and forged on. And yet the wooden buffer beam here on Coppernob almost seems like it's hardly attached at all to those bar frames. Most amazing that this thing is so light, almost so flimsy, but operates for the best part of 50 years. What's the story of this particular engine though? We've looked at the technical bits and pieces of why the Berry type is important, but what actually happened with this machine? Well, it was built as one of four locomotives for the Furness Railway, based in Cumbria. The Furness Railway knew this engine as number three, but throughout its working life, its distinctive looks gave it the nickname by which we much more know it today as Old Coppernob. And why is it called Coppernob? It's because this very distinctive copper cladding on the firebox gives the engine a look that nothing else can equal. The unique way in which Coppernob have its firebox clad with the copper sheeting was also then reflected in the beautiful burnished brass trim that we have around the wheels and the splashes. The splashes are there to stop mud and filth going up into the working parts. It doesn't have to be polished brass, but it is, and doesn't it look beautiful? And you can see how much love this engine has had over the years, in that the maker's name on the boss of the wheel, well, it should say Berry, Curtis and Kennedy there, of Liverpool, and it's been so vigorously polished that it's lost the lettering and is barely legible. Absolutely amazing. But another part of the look of the engine is this distinctive colour, this almost Indian red. And why is it this colour? Because in Cumbria, there's a lot of iron, a lot of iron ore, and some of that is called hematite. And hematite has a red colour. So it's the cheapest and easiest pigment that you can find to paint your engines in. So the Furness Railway began, whereas a lot of other railway companies had green engines, Furness Railway painted their locomotives this glorious Indian red and picked it out with black and vermilion lining. Absolutely gorgeous. Now on Curator with a camera, it's normal for us to take you into the cab or onto the footplate of a locomotive. But as you can see today, Coppernob hasn't got a cab. Why is there no cab? This engine has to run on the Cumbrian coast, where in all weathers, where you've got wind, snow, hail, rain, all in your face. There's not even a weatherboard for the driver to hide behind when the rain is parallel. It's incredible. No wonder these guys had these great bushy beards when you see them in the photographs of drivers and firemen, and they got mufflers tucking them into their jackets just to try and keep them warm. And the controls themselves, really, really basic. I mean, this engine is 1846 originally. It's only 16, 17 years after Rocket. The locomotive is still being developed. So there's the firebox door, which we can see in the back of this incredible firebox. The regulator valve on the back, in essence, how much steam is controlled to the cylinders. A single Salter safety valve to the front, another Salter safety valve on the dome to the rear, which control the pressure. So if the pressure gets too high on that gauge to the red line, then the safety valves will lift, releasing excess steam. A whistle, the audible warning, right there behind the dome. And then the reversing lever here itself for the engine to go forwards and backwards. And apart from a handbrake on the tender, that big wheel there, that's all the controls that you have with Coppernob. The most rudimentary engine, the most basic engine, but the most classic Victorian engine, embodying that period of locomotive design. So after a long working life to 1898, by 1901, Coppernob is so recognised as a symbol of Furness Railway pride and heritage that they put it in a glass case with an iron frame on Barrow-in-Furness station. Coppernob remains in its glass house for 40 years until a particular day in 1941. A bomb lands on Barrow station, and whilst Coppernob itself doesn't receive a direct hit, the force from the bomb blast smashes the glass shelter display area to smithereens. The iron frame is broken to pieces, and the shrapnel from the bomb does untold damage. So you can see here on the boiler casing, the firebox casing, all these dents and dings in what would have been a beautifully kept copper cladding. You can work your way along the boiler and you can see more bits where the paint has been chipped and flying glass and shards of iron have wrought their damage. But then we move to the boiler itself and we can see where, although the engine hasn't taken a direct hit, some of that shrapnel has punched clean through the locomotive's wrought iron boilerplate. An incredible, incredible testimony to the damage and the destruction that war wrought on our country and our heritage. But it is a really significant piece of locomotive engineering. And of course, it is now one of the icons of our collection. Thanks for joining us today for Curator with a Camera. If you'd enjoyed it, then please leave us with a like and maybe subscribe so you can see further episodes.